studio ever set up in the world was in the yard of my laboratory at West Orange. The building revolved to follow the sun. We dubbed it the Black Mariah.
See, and that's what I'm talking about when I say original music. I mean, that's not something you're going to hear on an everyday radio program like the Jay Stone Show. So, I believe they pronounce it the Black Mariah, I think, because there's some history around that song. You'd have to look into it. But that was the Cranberry Merchants. So I'm always honored to play new stuff on the show all the time, because it not only showcases new music, it showcases the Jay Stone Show too. So that's something else that works both ways. When you want to get played on radio stations and shows such as mine, that's what we want in return for putting your stuff on the air, is to promote it. And that's what the bands do for me. So, you know, and I get them out there to the people who return to my show every week. Now, next week, I might have two more listeners that, because of that song, that'll listen to the new band I'm playing next week. So it all compiles down the road. But yes, for everybody's questions out there, there will be changes. It's going to take time, because financially, it's going to take some money to make these things happen, video wise, and building studios and stuff like that. It has to look professional. Again, I no longer make real revenue from this show. Whatever couple of cents from you guys clicking on Amazon, or the 2 cents for 20,000 plays for the commercial before the show. But that's why video is moving too quickly, and this live stuff is everywhere, and that's where everything's being monetized properly. So, you know, I've been doing this show for 12 years, and I can tell you I'm definitely in the negative, because I do it for the love of what I do, not for anything else, not really for money. But if I make those investments, that will have to change. But there's things that you can't do on Facebook Live. You can't put this certain advertising in. So it becomes a whole nother thing. And the I understand copyright laws and publishing and the loopholes of everything, and what needs it and what don't, and why I can play it and you can't, and all of that. And video definitely changes that, because it's another aspect, and it's a visual on top of audio. So it's going to be a different type of multimedia, but all the details aren't worked out yet. There's a lot of people interested in coming on board. And remember, I still have to work a day job. So it's all got to coincide and gel together for everything to work properly. And then that audio will eventually be cut into a separate radio show. So things are going forward. John, my guitar player and segment producer out in Dallas-Fort Worth, Texas, is going to be interviewing the guys from the band Insight, who are on tour with Soulfly and their family or whatever. So not John and them, but Insight and Soulfly. They're somehow, I don't know the whole history of Soulfly. I was never the hugest fan of Soulfly. I like their music. I have a couple of their albums, but it was not something that I followed so close. I jam to them, if you know what I mean. So I don't claim to be a fan of something I'm not. Not that I'm not a fan, but, you know, not that there's anything wrong with that. But anyway, oh, Jerry Stiller, fucking, I do believe Ben Stiller's dad. I don't know if he passed away or whatever, or was rushed to the hospital or something, but funny man. I only got a couple more songs left to play. I blew through the most important news. There's nothing really out there to speak of. You know, it's the beginning of the year. I'm two shows in. I don't think anybody's died musically yet. So usually every week I have someone to talk about that's passed away in the music industry. But then again, I haven't had time to read much of the media, which is a good thing. So I don't know. I'm definitely looking forward to the next few days and getting some shit out of the way, getting some bills paid, and getting some of that stress off my shoulders. And looking forward to making these changes in 2019. So I hope everybody out there is off to a good start. Technically, with this board and shit, I'm not too happy, but you know what? I don't let that shit bring me down anymore, because I've been through every technical issue, and you know what? That's my life story. I'm surprised I didn't have to return the board or my pop filter or, you know, just anything. So far, I'm off to a decent start, trying to catch up. You know, since I sold my business and stuff, I've kind of lived off that money for the past year, bouncing around till I'm, you know, found the right job and stuff. Again, I don't always do everything to be rich, but, you know, it's not the easiest thing. That's because you're causing them to fucking, because you got fucking Dinky Rabbits. That's our dog's name, Dinky Rabbits. That's just what we call it. But anyway, I'm going to play a couple of more songs. I'll stop back and talk to you, and we'll wrap the show up because I got to go slap a few knuckleheads around. Here is The Fallen by Seven Factor. I'm Jay Stone. You listen to my show live at Rock Metal Talk. Dead cam, bitches.